Penguin Random House Audio presents Emily Post's Etiquette, the Centennial Edition, by Lizzie Post and Daniel Post Senning. This is the author, Lizzie Post. Note to listeners: this program includes a downloadable PDF that contains charts from the book. To Emily Post and all those who take care with each other, and in doing so, make the world a kinder place. Author's note. Dear listener, Etiquette lives, and we are thrilled to be talking about it with you. This 20th edition of Emily Post's Etiquette is a special one. Its publication marks the 100-year anniversary of Emily's famous book, originally titled Etiquette in Society, in Business, in Politics, and at Home, which was first released in 1922. Upon its debut, Etiquette was an instant hit. For many, it gave a window into the way America's high society lived, and at the same time offered a perspective on practical standards for living well with others, both at home and out in the world. Accessible and aspirational, Etiquette was updated and reprinted often in its early years, and has been revised by generations of the Post family since Emily's death in 1960. Whether Emily Post is a famed or perhaps feared name from your childhood, or her book a cherished keepsake passed down from a loved one, or new to you, it is an honor and a privilege to present this latest edition to you. While Emily's status in society was that of an older, wealthy white woman, her advice was anchored in principles that were effective and accessible for all, creating a long-lasting and adaptable foundation for her work. The consistent thread throughout is the idea that etiquette is about taking care of people and helping them feel at ease. What matters is the manner of a person, their kindness, thoughtfulness, and awareness of others, not the particular manners they have learned. As Emily explained, etiquette is not some rigid code of manners. It's simply how persons' lives touch one another. The editions of Emily's Etiquette were famous for their perspective, humor, and detailed depictions of daily life with all its successes and mishaps. With tales like How a Dinner Can Be Bungled and characters such as Mrs. Worldly, Constance Style, Mrs. Kindheart, and the Onceworths, she painted relatable pictures of what to do or not do. One of her most memorable characters was Mrs. Three-in-One, who was added to the book in 1927 to represent those playing the roles of host, cook, and maid all at once, which was most of Emily's audience. Today, nearly every adult is a Mrs. Three-in-One, and the Post family has added, subtracted, and made many revisions and updates to this book over the past 100 years to respond to changes in American culture. Emily certainly never saw a smartphone, and could not have anticipated the role social media plays in our lives. But even with all the changes and adjustments that our culture has seen in the past century, Emily Post's Etiquette still aims to equip you, our dear listener, with a sense of confidence and preparedness for some of the situations you'll encounter at home, at work, in your social life, and when you're out and about. Every few years, a headline declares that etiquette is dead. But through our work at the Emily Post Institute, we know that this isn't true. Our weekly podcast, Awesome Etiquette, has received thousands of etiquette questions from all kinds of people living all kinds of lives, multiple generations navigating living in the same home, students with group work dilemmas, folks who wish they'd received thank you notes, people grieving losses or celebrating unions, and everyone and their uncle wanting gift-giving advice for various occasions. From table-setting technicalities to the many ways to use titles and names today, to how to appropriately discuss relationship problems, we all do care about the interactions we have with others, and the fact that we care is what keeps etiquette alive. As long as we keep asking, what is the right thing to do? Etiquette lives. While tradition has, and always will, play a part in how we behave, good etiquette in any situation will always seek to create a positive and respectful experience for all parties involved. Many people associate the terms etiquette and manners with grand houses, elaborately set tables, and tidy, calm, pleasant people, an anachronistic picture that we at the Emily Post Institute aim to shatter, or at least expand dramatically. When etiquette is viewed through a lens of wealth and arcane coded behavior, it is elusive and exclusive. When seen through a lens of consideration, respect, and honesty, it is inclusive and accessible. At times, Emily Post's etiquette advice has been viewed as a mandate, with no room for error or exception, or as a saccharine sweet dream too idealistic for the world we live in today. But we see it as a barometer of North American social and business behavior, a response to what is happening, not a dictator of it or an impossibly perfect ideal. To think of etiquette as elitist or unattainable does a disservice to the universality at its heart. Etiquette is for everyone. We hope to inspire not just fancy dinner parties and handwritten thank you notes, but also acts of kindness, patience, compassion, awareness, and thoughtful behavior. These are things we all crave and that can spring naturally from sharing food, good company, and thoughtful conversation. Our goal is to provide a sense and understanding of what good etiquette looks, sounds, and feels like in our world today. There is often more than one right thing to do. The reality of our ever-changing circumstances requires us to think about and adjust our courses of action, often in a split second. Etiquette asks us not to rely on strict rules, but to think, to consider every aspect of a situation. It encourages us to look for a solution that benefits most, if not all, of the people involved. For all the distinct manners around utensils, handshakes, invitation wording, and knowing who introduces whom, being thoughtful is almost all it takes to show that you care and that you are trying, and hopefully succeeding, to be aware of and respectful toward those around you. This book celebrates 100 years of Emily Post's etiquette. We hope it will feel like a conversation about etiquette and not like an encyclopedia. We hope that you feel included in these pages and that you find ways to use the advice to fit your life, your style, and your voice. We hope to entertain you as Emily did, with humor and optimism. We offer suggestions for how to interact with others in ways that are both traditional and contemporary, and to encourage you to engage confidently with the world around you. Rather than continue the tradition of adding many new topics to this book, we have pared down the advice to focus on everyday etiquette and entertaining etiquette. Our guidance on weddings and business can be found in our other books on those topics, and advice on many other specialized topics, such as hiking, flag, and pet etiquette, can be found online at emilypost.com. We thank you for the opportunity to carry on the Emily Post tradition of changing with the times, both honing and developing our advice to be more inclusive of the many individuals trying to live well with one another in our collective society. We hope you find this book useful, encouraging, and fun, and that this new edition will be one you'll be proud to use and maybe, someday, pass down to a loved one. Always sincerely yours, Lizzie Post, Daniel Post Senning. Best Society. In 1922, the first chapter of Etiquette was about what was then called Best Society. Emily argued that this group's members were not necessarily those born to high society or to great wealth, even though many assumed this to be true, but was instead made up of gentlefolk who took care with each other. Best society is not at all like a court with an especial queen or king, nor is it confined to any one place or group, but might be better described as an unlimited brotherhood which spreads over the entire surface of the globe, the members of which are invariably people of cultivation and worldly knowledge, who have not only perfect manners, but a...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.